going on, guys? So today we're going to be taking a look at the Marvel Legends Walmart exclusive Thanos. Now, this figure was released a while back, but you can still get it new on eBay and probably even Amazon, but you're going to be paying a marked up price. This figure was one that was actually requested by viewers in my Marvel Collections video. I had a few people ask for me to do a review, so here we are. So let's go ahead and get the Mad Titan out of the box and take a closer look. Okay, so here we have Thanos out of the box, and he comes with two accessories. You get an alternate head and an alternate hand where he's not wearing the Infinity Gauntlet. And the alternate hand also comes with an alternate sleeve that goes along with it. The head sculpt that comes on him by default has him smiling, kind of with a menacing grin on his face. And then the alternate head is just him being more kind of somber. So now let's take a closer look at the paint deco, because I think that's what really makes this figure stand out. So with this Thanos figure, you get a nice deep metallic blue with silver accents along the side. And the gold accents that you get on here also have a nice shimmer to them. I think they did an amazing job with the head sculpts. That's one of my favorite features, obviously, because if they mess that up, it ruins the entire figure. His shoulder pad right here actually pegs into the shoulder, so you can lift it up. Just let me take his head off, I guess. That'll make it easier. So you can remove that and pretty much see where that pegs in. And if you put his head back on with the shoulder pads removed, you can have him pose like that. Still doesn't look too bad with the shoulder pads removed. The only thing is you have those two holes up there, but not really a big deal. There's also some nice art deco along his shoulder pad. So you get the gold along with the yellow in the inserts. And then you see this gold piece running down his spine. And he has a little gold skirt on as well, which has some detail in there that's not colored in, but it is etched into the plastic, so that's a nice touch. Looking at his boots, you can see the yellow design etched in running around the top of his boot. There's silver running down the front of it, and it goes into the knee joint area as well. So a lot of different colors went into this figure, a lot of variations that play off of each other. Really nice metallic blue though. I think that's what really makes this figure pop, along with the gold accents. On his head, you can see that he has the helmet on. There's some articulation around the top, and he has that famous Thanos chin right there. And on both head sculpts, his eyes are sort of a teal color, but it stands out nicely against the purple face. So now let's talk about articulation. Okay, so with Thanos, you'll be able to get him looking up that far, down that much. His arms feature bicep swivel. He has single jointed elbows, swiveling and pivoting hands, but the hands are somewhat limited by these gauntlet pieces that go around it. So when you try to get them to bend, sometimes the hand will pop off. And also when you get him to raise his hand up, it can cause the shoulder pad to come out of the peg, but you're usually okay if you spread it out far enough. So Thanos features ab crunch that'll get him leaning back this far, leaning forward this much. He does feature waist swivel, and while the belt does interfere a little bit, it's pliable enough for you to still get him to move around. With his legs, he features thigh swivel, double jointed knees, boot swivel, and ankle pivot. And for a quick size comparison, I have Thanos standing next to one of my favorite Captain America figures, the Marvel Now version. So you can see that Thanos is much larger than your average 6-inch figure. So now let's go ahead and move on to my final thoughts. Okay, so for my final thoughts, this is the only comic-based version of Thanos that I have, so I don't have anything else to compare him against other than the MCU versions, which wouldn't really make much sense. But it's really the only version that I want, because I love the design on it. I love what they did with it. It's accurate to the comics, as far as I can tell. So I absolutely love it. If you're considering getting him, I would say go ahead and pull the trigger. I mean, you're gonna have to pay a little bit more because it was a Walmart exclusive, but I think you'll be happy with it. So let me know what you guys think about this Thanos figure in the comment section. Thank you guys for watching. As always, thank you for your support, and I will see you on the next video.